Hey guys, it's Sunday. I was a little worried about the Georgia game yesterday, but I don't know what happened to Kentucky, but it did not look like the same team I saw last week. The video I have for you today, I'm just going over vacuum hoses and trying to make them ready to use and talking about something I saw Ted Cook do in one of his videos. I'm actually learning to use a new software for editing videos, and I do have a couple more videos in waiting, so stay tuned. This will be a short one. Hey guys, let's just say I have not been totally thrilled with the end result of the True Blue hoses. So I decided to get my my old vacuum hose out. I might use it a little bit. I just got to refurbish it. I have already taking this apart. This is a little adapter I got at United Refrigeration. Converts quarter to half inch, but you got to have this little piece right here, and I was able to do it with the Appion core removal tool, so that is something that I had to have. That's nice and tight. But yeah, I took that apart and it's got a little copper piece in it. So this is a flare quarter to half inch adapter. And it's got a little copper piece in there. You put some nylon on it and you tighten it down real good. And I had put some nylon on these, but I saw that they had been damaged. So I went and I picked up some more. This is what I had to do when I made this hose so I could use a half inch hose. Nobody sold a half inch to a quarter hose or an adapter that did like this, that goes to half inch. They have 3/8 to quarter, but nobody had a, and I still can't find a half inch to a quarter adapter. So that's how I made one, and it actually turns out to be okay. But sometimes when you use this, you've got two different core removal tools. But I have found that TruTech Tools, I forget who it was that sold a half inch hose with a half inch fitting down to quarter inch, and I ordered it. And I'm gonna use it. All right, come on. Thing has to go in straight or it ain't gonna go in at all. I'm having some trouble doing this. I might have to turn y'all off and put that in there. And this is something that I'm making. They're gonna see me pull the Schrader depressor out. I'm doing that on purpose. And I learned this from Ted Cook over on Anti-DIY. If you want to know if your Schrader is leaking, put one of these together, pull the Schrader depressor out, and when you plug it on, if you see any pressure, you know your Schrader's leaking. I thought that was a really good idea from Ted, and I'm not ashamed to say I stole that idea from him. Guys, I hope you enjoyed your weekend. I hope you got something out of this video. Thanks for watching.